And here's a giraffe. I have no idea. Yeah, the guy actually, you know, he said he wanna, he challenged to debate me too, you know, but he will not give me a Skype to call him. I mean, what kind of a job? You open a store to sell hijab. This is a job for a girl. Obviously, you are a womanizer trying to get women to come to your store. Like, imagine a man, he open a store for bikini. Yeah. Who's going to be customers? Women. Why you are interested in selling women? What about putting a woman in the store, not you? Obviously, he's a womanizer. Like Muhammad. And you know, by the way, he had the right to have four. So he, you know, four women, they got inside the store to buy hijab. He married them all for one day and he divorced them the second day. So do we have any Abdul? Do we have any Abdul to tell us, is it true that the Quran really have amazing facts, as you Muslim, you say? Is it true? Like, we go to your videos on YouTube. Let us see, this guy is trying to call. You cannot call me unless I accept your call. So you have first to text me and confirm that you are a Muslim. If you are a Muslim, I will not take your call. I would like to talk on the stream. Okay, are you a Muslim? Are you? When you text me, tell me if you are a Muslim or not. If you are not, then don't text me. I'm not going to take your call if you are not a Muslim. And if you are stupid playing games, I will block you right away. I will hang up on you. So if you are acting, trying to claim to be a Muslim just to call and to be funny, life, we will shut you down. Ex-Muslim. But I have a question about the prophecies about the Quran. How you can prove them wrong. Okay, because he's an ex-Muslim, we will take him then. Hello? Hello? Yes, my friend, you are live on air. So you are next Muslim? Do you hear me? Okay, do you hear me now?
Yes.
All right, you are next Muslim, you said?
Yes, and I have questions on how you can refute the prophecies said by Muhammad, because most of the prophecies are being proven true.
Like what?
So can you...
Like what?
Like they say about the unavoidability of riba in the end times.
But my friend, you see, this is stupid of them to say that, because interest is something, according to the Quran, the Jews, they practice at that time. So if the end of the time people, they practice riba, that means that the end of the time starts before Muhammad. So this is stupid to say. Even Muhammad, according to Muslims, they say he borrow money from a Jew, which means he paid him interest, because a Jew will not give you money unless you pay him interest. So if the judgment day will happen because people are corrupt and they are paying interest, that means Muhammad is the first one to be a corrupt person and he was paying interest. Otherwise, how he got the loan from the Jew, as the Muslim they claim?
Yes. And so what about they make the claim that there's going to be big tall buildings built in the
tall buildings
end time.
Is built before Muhammad. If you go study history, you will see that the Yemen supposedly, the Muslim they claim this is where the Arab coming from, according to them. So Yemen, and go right now search for, you know, like old building in Yemen, you will see very high buildings, and those are shepherd. You know, this is what they make living from. They grow shepherd and sheep, and they are naked. So so they have high buildings since the time of Muhammad. So if this is the case, well, Islam is a fraud. In the same time, Let us say, let us go for the sake of argument. If the judgment day will
Okay.
happen when the Arab have high building, okay, so why is it happening? What is that? You know, okay, the Arab have high building since long time ago. So where is the judgment day? Right? So when a Muslim he says something to you, I mean, it's very easy to refute the stupidity. Are you there, my friend? Hello?
Yes,
Okay, because I
but
lost
how can we prove to like the Muslims that this is true? Because they show us that the Middle East is becoming green again, and it's becoming like how Muhammad
The Middle East, my
prophesized.
friend, is dead, is not going green. That's stupid to say, with my respect to you. Because if I take the water from the ground and I water the grass in the front of my yard, that will not make the Middle East green. Actually, Jordan just bought millions of gallons of water. They paid money from it, from Israel. So they are desperate. Egypt is going to go in war with Ethiopia just because they built a dam. Syria and Iraq, they are dying because Turkey closed the river and they put dams on the rivers. So the whole Middle East have no water. And Emirat, their water is coming from the sea. They are spending a lot of money to make the salt water fresh water. So did the Middle East become a green? Absolutely false. It's the opposite. It's more dry. Don't the whole world speak about the global warming? Don't
Yes.
history and science, you go right now and see. I remember in Saudi Arabia, you know, a Swedish company, they build a phone, you know, phone center, like phone company, and they have an agreement of 25 years of use, which mean the government allowed them, okay, you build the company, you have customers, for 25 years you collect money. After 25 years, we take the company from you. When 25 years is over, the sand of the desert was already covering half of the center. So everybody knows about the sand and the desert is growing, not shrinking in the Middle East. So all of this is just a garbage, you know.
So,
The Saudi, let me
how
tell you
are
what.
these lies so far spread? Like
My friend,
the claims.
you see, if nobody wanna use his brain, those lies work. It depends how stupid, how smart you are, how educated, how much you search, how much you study.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And can you debunk the claim of embryology in the Quran?
Well, this is
Because
very easy. Actually, this is not only debunk, this is the proof that Allah is false God and Muhammad is a false prophet.
oh,
Yeah,
yeah.
because
Can you do it? Like,
sure, we do it
because in
right
the
now.
Quran. Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, because you know the Quran, you see, there is the easiest way to prove anything is to go to their books. And when the Quran says in chapter 23, verse number 14, as an example, and then that we made the sperm into a congealed blood.
Yeah.
How that can be a miracle, this is stupid. Because there's no scientist in the world agree that the semen will transform into a blood and that blood will become a baby. So the verse here says, and we made the sperm into a clot of a congealed blood. That means the sperm itself become a dead blood, and then that dead blood will become a lump, and that lump will become a piece of lousy material like bones, and then we make the bones, and then we close the bones with the flesh. So according to the Quran, the last thing is to close your bones, the last stage, and then Allah, then He closes you with the flesh, according to which science. So, and according to which science, a sperm will become a blood, and according to which science, the blood will become a lump. This is the whole stupid thing. And in the same time, the Quran make it so clear that the sperm is coming from the backbone of the man. So how in the world such a thing can be true? So all of this is a clear proof that Muhammad is a false prophet. Not to forget to mention chapter 86, verse number 6 and 7 says that the sperm of the man coming from the backbone, and the women have a sperm coming from her ribs. And we can open right now Ibn Kathir, and we can read the interpretation And everybody will laugh. So what the Muslim, they will say, we don't agree with the interpretation. What the Quran says that, not the interpretation. The interpretation is just saying what the Quran is saying.
So the many Muslim doctors are lying?
My friend, anyone who don't want to be honest, he can be dishonest. This is not, this is a choice people, they make. But for us, you see, we are not showing you a book made by somebody. He is a Christian. This is not a book made by a Jew or a Hindu. Those are their scholars, and those books is what they teach to their children. So when they're a scholar, they explain the Quran and say the following. Read with me carefully. I don't know if you can see the screen. He created the film from water gushing forth, meaning sexual fluid comes breast forth from the men and the women. Okay, continue. It says, meaning from the backbone of the man and the ribs of the women, which is referring to the chest. So how in the world? So are they blind? No, they knew. But you see, this is the whole idea. Islam is a big scam. And there's people, they make a benefit
the
from the scam.
Billions of people in the world are lying and playing this lie with each other.
When they lie, they are lying to themselves, not to us. Because here we go, it's in front of us. Here you go. This is Ibn Kathir. Is Ibn Kathir a Christian? Is he a Jew? Is he a Hindu?
No.
Okay, so what we will do? The second you ask them, they say, oh, open the interpretation. This is not what the Quran is saying. Okay, we open the interpretation. And now what they will say? Oh, Ibn Kathir is just a man. Well, Muhammad is just a man too. When Muhammad, he said this. You see, the master of biology is Muhammad, right? Dr. Muhammad. So when Muhammad, he says, if a man have an orgasm first, the baby will be a boy. In which science is that?
It's not science. That's just
that's not only
talk,
science. That is stupid, you know. So, so when Muhammad he said such a thing, obviously either he is just being stupid, you know, or trying to be smart. And, you know, speaking in front of people who do not know anything about medicine or biology. And at that time would work because they don't know, you know. let us put the hadith here. Here we go. This is the hadith in front of us. It says, Muhammad said, and this is sahih. They cannot say this is weak and, you know. It says here. The Messenger of Allah, he said, the water, the man water is thick and white, and the woman water is thin and yellow. Muhammad is expert with orgasm. Which one of them comes first, the child will resemble the parents. Okay, what do we do now? This is a prophecy. This is Muhammad making prophecy now, because this is supposedly nobody knows. Right?
That doesn't make sense.
Yeah, this is stupid. Not only the saying. What about Muhammad saying that the sperm stay inside the mother belly for 40 days?
No.
When, if we go to Prophet Gogol, peace be upon him, in Prophet Gogol, he will say that the maximum days for a sperm or semen to live is 5 days. 5 days maximum. So, Muhammad, he did not really make a big mistake. It just only, 35 days. That's all. You know?
Yeah.
It's not a big deal if you think about it. It is 5 days, but he's close. Because Muhammad said 40 days. What the difference between 5 days and 40 days? Not much. It's just a few weeks. What a big deal. Come on. You know?
Yeah.
It's just a month and, 2 weeks. Or let's say, a month and 1 week. A month and 1 week. Come on. It's not a big deal. Right?
So, all of Muhammad's prophecies were false.
All Muhammad's prophecy. There's no prophecy. This is stupid things. How in the world we can call them prophecy?
Because I did leave Islam, but it's hard to fight with these prophecies they give.
Come on, my friend. This is stupid, don't you see? Just watch my videos and take notes, and you will see how you can refute their stupidity. So did you leave Islam only and your family with you?
No, I just did myself. And usually when you leave Islam, they say like, oh, you're under jinn possession or something.
I noticed, by the way, when you call me that, you have a genie in your nose. Have you ever heard of a religion believe that shaitan, he sleep in your nose, piss in your ears,
No.
no, piss in your ears, sleep in your nose, and he jump at your mouth and when you are yawning.
So, like, you debunk Islam, but you're a Christian. So, like, what's the difference between Islam and Christianity? Because I left Islam and now I don't have a religion. So, I don't know if Christianity is true.
My
It
friend,
seems
my friend.
quite similar to Islam.
No, it's not. There's nothing, there's no connection between Islam and Christianity. Muhammad, because he's a scam, he used the name of Christ in his Quran, but just to be accepted. It's like the fake cable guy who come to your door. He say, hey, I want to install the cable for you, but in fact he is a thief. This is how Muhammad and what Muhammad is. So there's nothing whatsoever between Islam and Christianity. We have no connection. Islam is just a fraud, is a collection of pagan religions. So Muhammad, he took some from the Christians, some from the Jews, some from the Arab, some from the Persian, some from the fire worshippers, and he put it all together and he made a new religion. And he says, okay, this is my religion. So what Muhammad do is the same as many cult, or let us say political leaders, they do these days. They smile to everybody just to be elected, you know. So Muhammad, in the beginning, he was weak. He wanted to be accepted. He don't have army yet. So he said to the Christians, you will go to heaven. He said to the Sabian, he will go to heaven. But the Sabian, they worship stars. How the Sabian and the Christian and the Jew became a family. In chapter two, verse number 62, he said, just this is Joe Biden making a speech for election. He said, verily, verily, those who believe and those who they are Jews and those who they are a Christian and those who they are Sabian, because those are the three major religions at that time. I mean, there's nobody left.
So
And
Islam lies about
whoever believe in
Christianity.
Allah, okay, and whoever believe in Allah, which means nobody left, that's it, because all the Arab believe in Allah. And whoever believe in Allah on the last day and do righteous, he will go to heaven. Like, what the heck? This is a speech of election day of Joe Biden, who forgot his name. By the way, what's your name? Joe Biden. So your name is Joe Biden. Yeah. So you are not the senator, you are the president. So I want to say to you, my friend, as long as you left Islam, I'm very happy for you. What do you know about the Messiah?
Well, even though I'm an atheist right now, I do not know if Jesus existed. Like, is there proof?
Oh, for sure. What is the day today?
I don't really know. Wait, let me check.
Take your time.
It's 18 November 2021.
After Christ. Thank you very much. So even your computer run by Christ date, even your salary, even your watch, even your phone, even our conversation, even your everything. So when somebody says, I don't know if Christ exists, well, everything proved that the Christ exists. So for me, you want to be an atheist, this is your business, but atheism is just another stupid religion too, because
No, I don't have a religion, so I'm just scared to be fooled like I was by Islam, because
No,
I
I don't want you to.
escaped Islam.
I don't want you to be fooled. I want you to read the Bible. You can start reading from the book of Luke or the book of John, or whatever you want, book you want. And maybe I will advise you to do something. Maybe it's strange. Go, I don't know if you have a physical book of the Bible. Do you have any copy?
No.
No.
Oh, but I can buy one.
Okay, get one. And the Muslim, they will say to you, there's many versions of the Bible. Those are translation, my friend. Those are just translation. The original is in Hebrew or in Greek or in Aramaic. So a translation. And then maybe you can do little, let us say, little try. Hold the Bible in your hand, make like go quiet and say to you in your heart, Lord, show me something in this book if you are exist. And then open the book, whatever it's open, start reading.
So in Christianity, is Jesus God, or
he is
he's
God,
like part
absolutely.
of?
Yes, he is God. Yes. Yeah, he is our
Yeah,
Lord, he's
because
our Savior.
for me, Trinity is not confusing. I think it makes more sense than Islam does.
Well, my friend, God is almighty, and if God he
Yeah,
cannot
yeah.
be what he is, I mean, what are we going? Why the Muslim don't tell their God, how come you have a leg? Nobody asks him. Okay, well, your leg is made from what? Nobody asks him. The Muslim, they don't make fun of Mary having a child without a man. Why? Because the Quran says so. So the Muslims are hypocrite when they question things. But if Muhammad, he says there's Trinity, every Muslim will say there's Trinity. If he
Yeah,
said there's no Trinity, he will say there's no Trinity.
but Trinity makes sense because God can do anything, so
No, it's not about
God can.
it's not about only God can do any things. This is how God he is. Either you accept that God is God, and then you don't question, like, because if we want to question, we should ask us everything. We should question him, how you can be God? You know,
So how do we?
hey God, how you create this earth, man? Come on, tell me. Hello, you cannot do it. Prove it to me. So if we wanna start asking questions, I mean, we have to question everything. We have to question how God can be God, and how you can do this. Okay, how Jesus can walk in the water? Hello. Okay, how Jesus can make the blind see? How Jesus he is born without a father?
God.
So the Muslims are a hypocrite. They question only when they want, and they go blind when they want. I don't want you to be blind. I want you to question.
Yeah.
I want you to do the opposite. So
thanks.
I want you to be smart and not to accept something unless it is really, go into your
But
heart and make you
how do
believe
you
in it.
know that Jesus is just not like Muhammad? What if Jesus
Well,
is
first of
also
all,
like
I will give you a
Muhammad?
sentence. The Messiah, he said. He said, from their fruits, you shall know them. So what we need to do about Jesus is to examine the fruit of Jesus. As simple as that.
Yeah.
Because I can make a speech to you about me being good, right? I can claim to be the
Yeah.
best, but I can be the opposite. Actually, most of people who claim to be good, they are not.
Yeah, like Muhammad.
It doesn't matter really. Most of people who claim to be good, I don't trust them. I trust a person who says I am bad more than a person saying I am good.
So, did Jesus say he was bad?
No, he said, I am the good shepherd. And this is why we say, let us examine if he was good or not. So, if he passed the test, which he himself, he put the terms and the condition of it, then that's mean Jesus is not hypocrite. So, when Jesus in Matthew said, from you shall know them from their fruits, he speak about himself too. So, I advise you to examine the fruit of Jesus. Jesus, he never owned a slave. Jesus, he never killed.
Yes.
Jesus, he never fornicate. Jesus, he never cheat. Jesus never lie. Jesus never commit sin. Jesus never.
He didn't marry a 6-year-old like Muhammad,
and never get paid. I mean, you see, if you ask me, Christian Prince, are you good? I'm not going to say I'm good. I mean, I'm a sinner.
Yes.
I would be a big, big liar if I say I'm good. No, you see, the Bible says no one is good but God. When a person, he said to Jesus, are you? You are good. So Jesus said to him, why you say I am good? Only God is good. The Muslim would say to you,
but isn't
see,
Jesus
Jesus saying,
God?
Yes, but Jesus, he said in the same time, I'm the good shepherd. So he's saying to him,
oh,
how
okay.
You know that I am good when you know in the same time that this is a description will not be given to anyone save God. You know what I mean? How you know?
Yeah,
I
that
am.
Makes sense.
Yeah. So so Jesus, I can claim to be good too. You can claim to be good too. But talk is cheap. That's why I say to you, when Jesus said in chapter 7 in Matthew, from their fruit you shall know them, you can go and examine the fruit of Jesus. So if he said don't do fornication and he fornicate, well, that's mean Jesus is a liar. If he said, don't lie and he lie, well, that's mean he's a liar. If he say, whatever he said. So examine his fruits. If his fruit is wonderful, is his fruit and his act is in total agreement with his teaching, that means this person is perfect, and perfection is only for God. Jesus in the cross, you know, when they asked Jesus how to pray, like teach us how to pray, he said, say like this, our Father art of heaven. And then he said to them, forgive to us the same as we forgive to others. So imagine Jesus, he don't forgive, but he is the one is asking us to forgive. But look what Jesus did. In the cross, Jesus, he said, Father, forgive them. They do not know what are they doing. He's asking forgiveness for
Yeah,
who? Do you know?
that's very merciful.
For the one who's killing him right now. It's not like
Yeah.
this is later after the pain is gone, you know. I mean, right now they have nails in my hands, nails in my feet, and they are insulting me. They are rejoicing for my death. And then in the same time, I'm worried about them. And actually,
Yeah.
the mercy of Jesus here is not only about forgiving. He did say something very important to the Christians, because somebody might say,
What?
hey, let us go and
How did you say?
seek revenge from the Jews because they killed Jesus. Nobody now can say that. Why? Because Jesus said, forgive them, Father. They didn't know what they are doing. So if Jesus himself, he forgive them, I cannot say I'm going to go after the one who killed Jesus. You know what I mean? So
Yeah, I
his
left
mercy.
Islam because that wasn't the truth. So I'm really interested to know if Christianity is the truth because I'm impressed that you debunk Islam, but you are a Christian. And in my mind, Christianity is kind of like Islam. So I would love if that was disproven.
Well, didn't I just change your mind a little bit, at least,
Yeah,
about
you
Christianity?
did.
Yeah.
Yeah, you did.
So, what do you think?
Yeah, I'll look into it because I have respect for Jesus as a person, if he's real or not, because he is much better than Muhammad, who I used to follow.
My friend,
So.
I will tell you if Jesus is true or not. I am a person, since I was a kid, I take a gun with me wherever I go. I used to fight with people I do not know. I used to jump in a fight. I have no idea why I'm jumping in the fight. I see two people fighting, I jump in the fight. Like, you know, I see two guys fighting one guy, I jump with the one guy against the two guy. Why? I do not know, because I felt it's not justice, so I jump in the fight. So I was a person who jump into fighting, problems, trouble, for no reason. You know, like to the point, any fight happened, my parents, they blame me right away, even if I was not guilty, really. If anything happened in the school, they accuse me that I am behind it. So I have like a very, very bad reputation as a person who
Yeah.
jump into fight. So with Jesus, I am a different person now. I don't go and fight with people. I can still carry my gun, you know, but I don't fight anyone. So Jesus can change you and make you a better person. But with Muhammad, will make you a terrorist.
Yes, that's why I left Islam, because
So yeah,
it
so.
wasn't the truth.
Without Jesus, I was, let us say, a terrorist. You know, I terrify everybody. So with Jesus, I am not. With Muhammad, you convert to Islam today. You were a nice person all your life. You join Islam, you became a terrorist second day.
Yeah.
So with Jesus, you will be the opposite. Without Jesus, is different person. So if Jesus is not real, how Jesus had changed me and made me give my time and give my work to serve him. To save Muslims from him. We love Muslims, we don't hate them.
So, how do you know the word of Jesus? Where do you get it from?
The Bible. That's why I
Is
said to
it
you.
written by Jesus?
You know, it have to, you know, you see, when we say it is written by Jesus, why Jesus need to write it? Because Jesus, he was speaking to thousands of people and he had disciples. And he said to them, go and teach what you heard from me. So it was the duty given to the disciple to teach and preach and carry on the word. At the same time, Jesus, he said, the sky, which means the heaven and the earth, will disappear or will be dissolved, but my word will be always protected. So the teaching of Jesus is not a book, is what
Yeah.
came to us with his, let us say, amazing work. So, because book is a way of transmitting information, because we die, right? We die, we don't stay alive. So okay, now I have an idea. I'm going to write it so when a child is born, 60 years after, he can read my idea, right? So because we don't live forever, we write books. But for God, there's no need for books. That's why when the Muslim they say that Allah have a book, that's stupid to say. I mean, why Allah have a book? He's eternal, according supposedly. Why would I write a book? Do Allah have a bad memory? I write a book because I will die, because I will not exist after maybe 10 years, maybe 20 years, maybe tomorrow. I don't know. So we write information so we can carry on the information to coming generation. But the word of God is with God always, and always he can keep it with his own people. So, and you know, Jesus, he said, to make the whole Bible so short, he said, wish to others what you wish to yourself. This is the book. That's it. Wish to others
So,
what do you
to
wish?
know more about Jesus, I'm supposed to read the Bible.
Yes, for sure.
Okay.
Don't you want to know what he did? Don't you know what he said? Don't you want to know his
Yeah.
teaching?
I do. But my question to Christianity is just like, what if someone doesn't know about Christianity? Will they go to hell?
Well, you know, let us make it simple. If I am a person who work in the fire department, I come to your house and I knock at your door and I say, hey, there's a smoke is coming from your roof, you know, there's a fire. And you say to me, I don't care, get out of here. No, I don't believe you. And then the fire came and ate you alive. Do you blame me or you blame yourself?
Myself.
Okay, this is what Jesus did. So God, he sent his only begotten son to save you, saying to you, there's a fire is going to come to your house and will eat you. And you say, I don't care. I don't believe you. This is your business. We believe in free will. So free will is your decision where you want to go. You want to be with him or you don't want to be with him.
Yeah, but what about places like North Korea where you're not allowed to be Christian? What
My
will
friend,
happen to them?
all those have an answer in the Bible. As an example, let us say a person, he never heard about Jesus.
Yeah, so.
Okay, that person will be judged by what God gave him, which means the knowledge he has. So let us say a person, he's born in the jungle of Brazil. He have his own savage life, etc. Those people still, God will be just with them. He will not judge them with somebody, the same as somebody he received the Bible. So
Yeah, that
God,
seems fair.
yeah, so when God, he created you, he put inside you, humanity, which is a feeling of a human. So when you rape a woman, you know it's bad, right? When you see somebody is crying, obviously you made him sad, right? You do not need to be genius. When you steal, you know this is not yours. When you kill, you know that this is blood and this is ugly. You should not do that. So even those who don't have book of God, God, he put inside them some knowledge about right or wrong. Let us say it's something born with you. So God will judge them by what they know, nothing else. It's like
Thank you, Sebi.
the same for a child. Yeah, the same for a child. If a child is born yesterday and he died tomorrow, okay, is God going to judge him because he don't believe in Jesus? No, because he's a child, you know? So he will go to heaven because simply he did
So it's
not do
not
any.
like Islam.
No, it's not. No, my friend. God is about justice, and justice is you will be given and you will be questions about what you've been given. Nothing more, nothing less. So
So there's
if you
no.
take from me, I will explain to you. If you take from me 1 pound, why I'm going to ask you for a dollar when I gave you a pound? So I give you a pound, I question you about the pound. I give you nothing, I question you about nothing. So a child, he was given nothing. So I will not question you about anything.
So it's not like Islam where Allah decides everything and you cannot change it.
Yeah, they believe in destiny. We don't believe in that, you know. We believe
So
that
there's no
we have a
predestiny.
free will. No, we have a free will. This is why Jesus said, not everyone says to me, God, God, will enter the kingdom of my Father, but the one who do his will. So you have to do the will of the Father. It's a choice, but you don't have to if you don't want. It's up to you. So those who do the will of the Father, it is his will, but still you choose it yourself, which means, okay, this is his will, and now should I follow it or not? This is your decision. So we don't believe in such a thing. It's called destiny. I can say we have little kind of destiny. Let's say it's a destiny since Adam commits sin that we are going to die, right? I can't change that. So I can say this is a kind of destiny is exist, but this is not what Islam believe in. Islam believe that your act is a pre-written in the book of God, and he decide for you what you will do. So what the point of judging me for something he forced me to do?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Islam, so it's not like Islam that in
simply,
Christianity.
Islam simply is a stupid religion, you know? It doesn't make sense in every word and every mean. Anyway, my friend, go read the Bible and I will be happy. I will give you some time. Call me again, maybe some other time, but just remind me because I have tens of thousands text me in this stupid Skype, you know? Just tell me I'm the one who spoke to you before and I'm ex-Muslim, blah, 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 you know? And I will call you.
Yeah.
Anything else,
thank
my friend?
Thank you, CP.
You're welcome.
No, nothing.
Should I ask you from
I'll
there if you don't
it.
Mind to say? If you don't talk to say,
no.
Okay, no problem. All right, take care, my friend. God bless you.
Yeah, thanks, CB. Bye.
Bye-bye. We'll pray to our friend here. We ask all the Christians to pray for this nice gentleman to see the truth, and the truth will set him free. Right? This is what we can do. You know, we help them. Now, here we have a Muslim. He said something here. Let me put it on the screen while I was talking to this gentleman, the ex-Muslim. Okay, I will call you the one who says Muslim here. Give me a second, my friend. Proud transphobe. I don't know what does that mean. Hello, CP. If you say Quran miracles are laughable, why Jesus turning water to wine false or genus or the Genesis? I'm not sure what you mean. The one who made the question, can you make your question more clear? What do you mean? I don't know. Why Jesus turning water to wine false? The question doesn't make sense. Do you believe it or you don't believe it? You see, if you read the story, you will see that Jesus, he don't really, it's not his interest to make the water wine. His mother, she asked him, do something. Those people need your help. He said, my time did not come yet. But here there is something you need to remember. Why Mary, she asked her son such a question or such a request? I want people always to think carefully. How many mother of us, she go to her son and she said to him, make water wine. Or even she did not even say, she said, you know, they are out of wine. I mean, how in the world this request happening? Obviously, Mary, as the Bible tells, from the beginning, she knew when the angels told her about who is Jesus, what Jesus he will be, who is this person she is going to carry, she will deliver. So the mother of Christ, she knew very well she is asking who for the impossible, because that is impossible. We bring you water. You make it wine right away. So she is not asking for something is possible. She is asking for the impossible. But the question is, why she was sure that he can do such a thing? This is telling us that Mary, she was one of the first believers in Christ. Correct? She believed, and she believed heavily that Christ is the one to ask impossible to.
Chapter 2. On the third day, there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Now both Jesus and his disciples were invited to the wedding. And when they ran out of wine, the mother of Jesus said to him, they have no wine. Jesus said to her, woman, what does your concern have to do with me? My hour has not yet come. His mother said to the servants, "Whatever he says to you, do it." Now there were set there 6 water pots of stone, according to the manner of purification of the Jews, containing 20 or 30 gallons apiece. Jesus said to them, "Fill the water pots with water." And they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, "Draw some out now, and take it to the master of the feast." And they took it. When the master of the feast had tasted the water that was made wine, and did not know where it came from, but the servants who had drawn the water knew, the master of the feast called the bridegroom. And he said to him, "Every man at the beginning sets out the good wine, and when the guests have well drunk, then the inferior. You have kept the good wine until now." This beginning of signs Jesus did in Cana of Galilee, and manifested his glory. And his disciples believed in him.
I mean to that.
After this, he went down to Capernaum, he, his mother, his brothers.
So here, you see that Mary, our beloved lady, she said to them, "Do what he will say." She was sure that he will not reject her request. At the same time, she was sure that the impossible is possible when it's come to Jesus. See, she did not even say to him, "Make water wine." She said, "They're out of wine, do something." Isn't it amazing? So this is why with the Messiah, I mean, those stories are amazing. And for sure, some people would say this is fiction. This can't be true. Well, my friend, I believe that the fiction, which was not a true yesterday, is a true yesterday. Which means it was a fiction 20 years ago when they make a movie that somebody going to the space. Today they are going to the space. It was a fiction that there's a flying car. It's true today. It was a fiction that there's a car, and it's true today. It was a fiction that we will speak from far distant to each other, and it's happening today. So if the man, he can make what was fiction true, what about God? Are we listening, people? If I came, let us say, 1,000 years ago, and I say to people, "You can speak from China, and I will hear you from America," people will put me in the hospital of crazy people. They will say, "This is stupid, it's mad." You know, people will make fun of you. "You're stupid, literally stupid." But this is what's happening today. And nobody is shocked. And nobody is surprised. Why? Because we're used to it. When somebody speaks from a studio, and then the image comes to you in your TV screen, how? I'm just connecting to the electricity. I'm not even connected to the internet. How the image of this person come to my TV? That is impossible. But it's true, and it is possible. So what was impossible, it turned to be possible. Which was fiction, is it true? Radio waves exist, but we cannot see it. So why do they believe in God? If you believe a radio wave, I will not believe in God unless I see God. Do you see a radio wave? We don't. Thank God we don't. Otherwise, we will see nothing but phone calls around us. You know what I mean? So my friend, for me, the intelligence is, it's not about Jesus, he can do miracles or not. Let us say, for the sake of argument, Jesus, he did maybe 0 miracles. But the real miracle is to make a human being a different, new human being. Jesus, he bring us back to our humanity when everything around us work hard to turn us into animals. This is the real miracle of Jesus. His miracle in us. not in walking water, not in making the wine out of water, not in healing the blind man. Even the blind man, he said to Jesus, Jesus said to him, what do you want? He said, I want to see. I mean, the blind man, he was able to see Jesus better than us. Because why in the world the blind man is asking somebody walking by, I want to see. I mean, if I'm a blind man at that time, I need a sandwich, I need a food, I need a shelter. But I'm not going to ask somebody walking by to make me see. Unless I see him better than everybody around, I can see that this is the person who can make me see. So the blind man in the time of Jesus was better than many of us today who have eyes, but yet they cannot see what Jesus can do. Not only God can do miracles, Jesus the Messiah, he is a miracle. And this is why when Muslims, they say great things about Muhammad, I love. Muhammad is not a miracle. He never did miracle, and he is an idiot. He's a child molester, he's a criminal, he's a thief, he's a liar. He went to his own son, and he flirted with the wife of his son. I mean, how far faith can go? So we can't even compare between the Messiah as a person. Even if you are a person, you don't want to believe in the Messiah as God. But there's no better person than the Messiah. Do we have any Muslim want to say anything? Okay, we have somebody here. He said to me, I'm a Muslim. We tried to call him. It might be ultimate fault, you never know. Let us lower the ring until he answer. Hello? Hello? Hello?
Yeah, that's Daddy.
Here we go. Stupid idiot. Go watch your videos, the last ones, and laugh at yourself. I do not know. Okay, what is that? Doesn't matter. Who? What Allah created first? It doesn't matter. I know it's you, you idiot. Before you call me, by the way, does that make me prophet? I acted like one. I mean, from all the Abdul in the world, I did not get anything except this chicken. This person present to us how Muslims are so confused and how Islam make you stupid. I do not need to know Arabic to understand the Quran. Okay, what translation you accept? I don't accept any translation. Okay, choose one. Rashad Khalifa. We go to Rashad Khalifa, we find that missing half of the Quran is missing. He adds sentences, he takes sentences, he puts sentences. All right. Sorry, guys, I'm coughing. Let us see. Do we have any Abdul? Anyone? Any real Abdul? My prophet, he said, O Fatima, Gabriel told me that my family will be the first to meet me, so it come true. Let me show you a miracle of Muhammad. him after he met his family that Jibril told him that he will meet his family. Look at this miracle. You know, when we are talking about Jesus walk in water, make the water wine, make the dead alive, give the blind eyes, heal the leper, feed 1,000 from nothing. Muhammad told him, Jibril told me I'm going to meet my family. And he told him that after he met his family. That's deep. Answer this. How we can answer this? Can you answer this? Sure, I cannot answer it. It's like the prophecy about the Roman, they will be victorious. Muhammad, he made the prophecy about after the victory happened. It's like saying Trump, he will win the election of 2016, Christian Prince. It is 2020 now, 21. What 16 talking about? This was a while ago. Yeah, this is a prophecy. Trump, he will win 2016 election. Like, listen, this was many years ago. Already he won, and now he is not the president no more. I'm telling you, this prophecy. He will win the election in 2016. Oh boy. Actually, if we go in the books of the Hadith, read this one with me and love. Abu Sa'd narrated, on the day of Badr, the Roman had victory over the Persian. Okay. So the believer were pleased with that. Then the following verse was relieved. Alif Lam Mim, the Roman being defeated, up to saying they will be victorious. Like, what the heck? So Muhammad, he received the verse about the Roman will be victorious after they become victorious. How that is, man, this is so deep. So now the Roman, they've been victorious over the Persian. And now Muhammad making a prophecy, the Roman will be victorious. But Abdul, they just did. By the way, I have many prophecies, if you remember, you know, as an example, many years ago, I mean, nobody before me said that. I said many women, they would have their period this month. Do you know how many they had that month specifically? That's so deep. Muhammad is a prophet. And not only that, as long as we are talking about the Roman, look at this one. Muhammad, he claimed that judgment day will not come unless the Roman will become the major population of the earth. Like, what the heck? What? The Roman, they will become the major population of the earth? That's deep. Let me see. Let me find the hadith. Man, how Muhammad, he knew this? Let me try to find it. Hold on. As long as I mention it, I'll find it. The Roman, you know, this is Italy, Italiano, hey, Tony, Bambino. So, according to Muhammad, that the Roman, they will be the majority of mankind. How that? The population of Morocco is way bigger than the population of Rome, I think, of Italy. And actually, even the population is shrinking. Look at this prophecy, and this is sahih. They cannot say it's weak. I heard Allah Messenger saying the last hour would not come until when the Roman would become the would form the majority among the people. Look at this. So the majority are not the Asian, are not the Chinese, are not the Indonesian. It's the Roman. Somebody's saying a Roman Catholic. That is very silly. The Roman is Roman. Roman is a first of all, there's nothing called Roman Catholic. This is, you know, this is later a name given to a church. Because in the beginning, both of them, they were fighting over the name Orthodox, not Catholic. Secondly, Roman is an ethnic. And then when those Roman, they occupy other lands, there's people being given citizenship, but they are second citizen, not first citizen. So the Roman is a group of people who they are coming from a certain location in this earth, and they are a small, tiny place as a population. So how they are the majority of mankind? He did not say the Christians, he said the Roman. Because the Christian is not only the Roman, remember. The Christian, even Muhammad himself, he went to the king of the Ethiopian, who is a Christian, right? The Egyptian, they are Christians. The Aramaic are Christians. They are not Roman. So he said the Roman. And by the way, here, this will prove Muhammad to be stupid again, because the Muslim, they keep saying that Islam is the fastest growing and Islam will dominate the earth. And then Muhammad, he says, well, the Roman will be the majority. Fix that. Roman is coming from the Rome. Yeah, those who belong to the capital of Rome. The citizen of Rome. And now, where is the citizen of Rome? Fix it, if you can fix it. And not only that, Muhammad, he predicted that the Muslims will be the most little religion in the world. So Muhammad, he predicted Islam to shrink and to become the most small one. Let us see if we can find the hadith in English. Give me a second. Okay, here we go. See it? So Islam starts as a small religion and will end as a very small religion. Is Muhammad a true prophet? Muslims? If Muhammad is true prophet, Islam should shrink and die. And the reference in the front of you. Right? So Islam must shrink in order for Muhammad to be a prophet. All right, we have somebody trying to call. This is from before. From yesterday, Sunday. Oh, this is old calls. All right. Any Muslim? Mayday. Anyone? I want a Muslim to make a video and tell us why Muhammad did lie, because you Muslim keep saying Islam is growing. You remember the gentleman who called me and he said he's an ex-Muslim, and he said the Muslim, they say that the prophecy of Muhammad, the Arab will have high buildings. Okay, and this is a sign of the judgment day. All right. But based on this, Islam should be small. To the point there's nobody, because the same as Islam is started with 70 people, this is the end, which means will be maximum 70 people. Another way that Muhammad claimed Judgment Day started since the moon split. If you go to the chapter of the moon, which is very funny chapter, you see one of the funny things about Quran. The Quran, there's no introduction for what's happening. Suddenly, okay, the hour has drawn near and the moon has been cleft asunder. Okay, what happened? And then here between two brackets, it says, the people of Mecca requested the Prophet Muhammad SAW to show them a miracle. So he showed them the splitting of the moon. Hey, guys, who want me to make a miracle? Let me search for the date of the eclipse. Okay, I'm going to split the moon for you, all right? I mean, it doesn't say who did the split the moon. The translation here, by the way, is very funny. Because in Arabic it says, اقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر. The judgment day is near and the moon split. Who split it? Nobody knows. When? Nobody knows. What happened? Nobody knows. Secondly, if you change the translation, right away you will see the whole chapter, the whole verse changed in a miraculous way. This is how corrupt this religion is. Look, that's it. There's no show the miracles, no. The hour, between two brackets, the judgment day is night, and the moon cleft asunder. So what is this verse claim? That this is not a miracle only, it is a sign of the judgment day. It is a sign. I am a Muslim, not a scholar. This is maybe ultimate fault again. No, this is not ultimate one. Hello?
You can avoid daddy. Daddy,
okay,
daddy.
Ultimate fault. Okay, ultimate fault.
Daddy, daddy, okay, daddy.
Okay, you see, because we are out of customers, let us laugh. Explain to us this verse. Explain to us this verse.
No.
Yeah, explain.
We got to go back to 424. Remember? He said 424.
You're just a stupid idiot. I gave you a chance, you idiot, but you're a dummy, as usual. Go back to 424. This guy, he can't sleep since then. He go in the market, he say 424. He go to the grocery store, the quick Christian present to me with 424. He cannot live without it. Abdul, go to Quran 424. Potato. Go back to 424. I mean, from all the Muslims in the world, I got nothing except this watermelon, which is damaged inside. Go to 424. Okay, do you know how to read it? Go to 424. Oh boy. Go to 424. Yeah, this is what happened last time. We it became history since then. No, go to 424. Yeah. Anyway, do we have any real Muslim? This person, by the way, he will never leave my chat. This is what happened when somebody get humiliated and he tried to retain his honor, which he have none of it. He called the Arab stupid, donkeys, fool, and his prophet is an Arab. He said, whoever believe in the hadith is a stupid donkey, and his prophet is the one who made the hadith. He said that he do not need to know Arabic, and he understand the Quran without knowing Arabic, when the Quran says, we never send a messenger to his, unless he is sent to his people speaking his their tongue, so it might make it clear for them. So he's getting his God busted by saying, we do not need to know Arabic, because why I need to know Arabic? I can understand the Quran perfectly without knowing Arabic. But his God says, no, I send my messengers in the tongue of the people, his people, so they might understand, so it make it clear. So you stupid donkey who don't want to leave my shoes, we spank you 100 times. It's time for you to go. Just go find different person to harass you, stupid. I mean, come on. You see how stupid you are. You do not need to know Arabic. So the Quran saying, it will not be clear to you unless you speak the tongue of the messenger. So when you say you do not need to be speaking Arabic, you are going against the Quran again. Stupid idiot. Certified idiot. Not only stupid, you are a certified idiot. Literally. Literally. Anyway, CP, at least give him a chance. His own dear brother. No, we have enough of this kid. I'm not going to waste my time, you know, screaming and etc. You wanna laugh? Go watch his videos. All of them, they are recorded and they are there. I know many of you are just coming here to be listening to a stupid idiot like him. You want comedy. You are not interested of learning. What is the benefit of me talking to such a person who say whatever he wish? What is that would do to you, Abby? What exactly that would do to you? This guy, he don't agree with anyone. He make his own answers, which nobody agree with, even from Muslims. So why you want to give him a chance? For what? Isn't it enough all the chances we gave him before? Or you are desperate for a comedy? Or maybe you are silly. Give him a chance. So all this time we take calls from those people. The same person, he called me for the last century. Until now, I did not give him a chance. Give him a chance. Some people are weird. Okay. Okay. You hate Islam? Okay, hold on. We have a Muslim here is angry. And as you know, we want Muslim point of a view. Okay. Look what this guy he's just saying. Be my witness. He is saying that, not me. He said, your hate for Islam and your evil, I think you mean evil, love will never stop our perfect deen from entering into each and every household in the entire universe. My friend, that happened long time ago. Open the TV stations right now, you will see a terrorist attack in London, a terrorist attack in Norway, a terrorist Muslim attack in Nigeria. So you Islam enter every house long time ago. Secondly, you idiot. We just showed you your prophet saying Islam is dying and is going to die. So what we would do with that? What we would do with your prophet who keep making poo-poo? Huh? What is this? If Islam will enter every house, why your prophet saying Islam start as small and will end as small? So who is the liar, you or Muhammad? Are you there? Potato? Mr. Aman? Aman, Rabbi Aman. This is Mr. Erdogan. So are you saying your prophet is a liar? Do you just say Did you just insult your prophet? Are you saying that when the prophet says Islam start as a small, tiny, and will end as a small, tiny, he did lie? Are you there, Aman Rabbi Aman? Aman Rabbi Aman, be honest with me. The Muslims now, they will say that you are sent by a Christian prince and I paid you 5 hamburgers to say this statement. Be honest, did I pay you 5 hamburgers? Aren't you a Christian undercover? Are you making fun of Prophet Muhammad? It sounds fishy for me. I think Christian Prince, he paid you to say such a statement so Christian Prince can show this hadith and then everybody will laugh at Muhammad. Brother, don't forget to contact me. Because later Allah will pay you 5 hamburgers. My prophet never lied. Will your prophet say his Islam will shrink? And you said no. Guys, look at this. I mean, what those people eat? What they eat? Somebody tell me. My prophet never lied. Okay, but you just said, you just opposed yourself. You said to me that Islam will enter every house. Your prophet said Islam will die. So what we would do now? And as long you are saying my prophet never lie, well, okay, that's me, you did lie. Choose one. My prophet never lie. Ah, so your prophet, when he says the one have orgasm first, the baby will look like him. He does not lie. No wonder Muhammad, he never been able have to have babies because he never have orgasm. Actually, even the hadith, by the way, proved that Muhammad never had orgasm and he never gave his wife orgasm. There is one of the comment, by the way, about this, the previous video, he says, when Muhammad, he says, no disease which the Negla seed does not provide remedy. He said, Christian Prince, it's very well known that this Negla seed help in every disease. Abdul, it says cure, shifa. It doesn't say it help because all seeds will help. Tomato will help. Do you know that? If you eat tomato, it's very healthy. If you eat even grass, it's very healthy. So it's not a secret that everything in our body, we are what we eat. So food supply affect our health. And seed in general are very useful for a human being. So when Muhammad, he said, he did not say this seed will help to fight illness. He said, وَمِنْهُ شِفَاءٌ مِنْهُ شِفَاءٌ. Read in Arabic. From it is the cure. The cure. There's no need for other things for the cure. So when Abduli tried to fix it, he make it blind. Muhammad, he did not say, it will help you. He did not say, it can make you stronger. No. He says that from the black seeds, there is the cure. So if you have cancer, you do not need anything except the black seed. Right? This is, now, here we go. Ultimate 40 will not stop trying to call me. He's in the heat. He got his period. Oh boy. What do I do with this guy? Yes, my friend. Hello?
Hello. Yes, hello.
Yes, you are a Muslim, right?
Yes, I am a Muslim.
All right. Can you speak louder, please?
Yes, sir.
So what do you like to say to us? What do you like to share with us about life on air, as you know?
Sir, can I talk about something else that you are talking on the YouTube? Can I talk about some other topic?
Okay, what topic you want to talk about? Go ahead.
Sir, basically,
Don't call
firstly,
me
I
sir.
would like you to.
I'm like you. Nobody is sir of anybody. Speak to me as you wish. My name is Christian. Feel free to call me Christian.
Okay,
thank you for being polite. I appreciate that. But, you know, I mean, there's nobody.
Okay, brother.
Go ahead.
Okay, brother.
All right.
So, brother, I would like to ask you a question.
Sure.
That do you believe that there is prophecy of Jesus Christ present in Torah?
There's a prophecy about Jesus Christ in the Torah?
Yes. This
well,
is my question.
All the Torah, all the Torah is a prophecy, because if you read, as an example, Genesis 5, you will see that the names, even the names of Adam, they are prophecies about Jesus.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
So likewise, I would like to say that as the prophecy, as the Jesus Christ was foretold in Torah, so likewise, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was also foretold in Bible.
Okay, so Muhammad is mentioned in the Bible?
Yes.
Okay.
I cannot exactly figure out
which
verses.
Which Bible? When you say Bible, Bible is a mean book of books. When you say Bible, the Bible is book of books. So which book?
Sir, I do not exactly know the reference, but I have a Protestant friend. I have one friend who is Protestant.
Okay.
And when I asked him that Prophet Muhammad is foretold in the Bible, so he said that Prophet Muhammad is not foretold in Bible, but the Bible says about the Holy Spirit. That is not Prophet Muhammad, but Holy Spirit.
Okay.
So can you also tell me about those verses? If you
yeah,
know
well, I mean, if you read those verses, you will see it's speaking about a spirit, and that spirit is not Muhammad, because Muhammad is not spirit, he's a man, right?
Yes.
Okay, so there's no need even to talk about it. So when the Muslims, they try to find Muhammad desperately in a book, in the same time they say that this book is corrupt. Isn't it? This is really crazy. What do you think?
Yes, exactly. They say that okay. Bible is corrupt.
So why I want to look for my prophet in a book? I believe it's not a book of God anymore. This is a crazy. So the question is for you as a Muslim, you should ask yourself why Muslims can't prove that Muhammad is a prophet from their book. Why they can't prove that?
Pardon
to us? What
me,
do you think?
Pardon me, brother, but I would give you an argument likewise that as we believe that Bible is corrupted. But we give the evidence from Bible. Likewise, you also, the Christians also think that Torah is corrupted, but you also
No,
give
that's not true. No,
evidence.
That's not true. Not a single Christian can say that Torah is corrupt. That's false. We accept all the Old Testament. This is why if you go and get the Bible now, you will find that the Old Testament and the New Testament is called the Bible. It's not just the New Testament. So whoever told you that, that's false. Secondly, the Muslims, when they say, this is what they say in YouTube, right? That the Bible is corrupt,
yes, yes.
But the Quran says the opposite. If we go right now in the Quran, we will see the Quran saying that the Quran confirm what is with them.
Yes.
Okay? Lima ma'ahum.
Yes,
I don't know if you speak Arabic. So the Quran doesn't say for what it used to be with them. It says what is with them. So a book came, confirm what is with them, chapter 2, verse number 89. And there's many verses, not only that.
Yes, yes.
So when their book says, when the Quran says, and this is your book, says, confirm what is with us, and then you say to me, your book is corrupt, who is the crazy here?
No, sir. Actually, the argument that basically that the Gospels are corrupt is that there are so many versions of Gospels, like Gospel of Luke, Gospel of John, and Gospel of Matthew, but
the version
of Quran
is just one. My friend, no. You see, with my respect to you, I'm not trying to insult you. This is ignorant of
yes,
you
brother.
To say so, because this is not a version. The Bible of Luke is the Bible according to Luke. It's different from the
yes, brother.
So this is not different version. Four writers for the same story. So this is the Bible. This is not different version. This is not a new Bible. Our Bible is four books. This is our Bible. Our book is four book, not one.
Yes.
So you got it wrong. Secondly, isn't it the Quran says that the Quran teach that Jesus have disciples and he asked them to help him to spread the message? So those are the disciples. Same time, your prophet, he says, خذوا القرآن عن أربعة. Take the Quran from four.
Yes,
okay.
Exactly.
So based on this, you Muslims should have four Quran according to four people.
No, sir. That is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that you should learn Quran from four people,
exactly.
And that are the Sahabas.
Okay, so learn Quran from four, and now we have many versions of the Quran. It's not four. Even your Prophet says that Allah, He sent him the Quran, seven Quran, correct?
No, they are basically the dialects of the Quran, that how to recite the Quran.
No, my
they
friend, are, if it's how to recite, this is not a new Quran then. This is silly to say how to recite. Because the story is...
Sir, I would just like to give you an example. Like in Surah Duha,
okay.
It starts with Vadduha. So there are different dialects. We can say Vadduha, Vadduhe, Vadduhi. So these are dialects.
This is false argument. This is not true. Because there's a huge difference between those Quran. As an example, is it Khalifa or Khaliqa? You know, you recite Al-Fatiha, right?
Yes.
Okay. Does it say Ahdina Surat Al-Mustaqim?
Yes.
Okay. What does Sirat al-Mustaqim mean?
The straight path.
Okay. Don't you know that in the book of Warsh, it is Al-Durat al-Mustaqim?
No, I don't have this in my knowledge.
Okay. Al-Durat is a fort.
Mm-hmm.
So how that lead us to the straight fort?
Yes.
This is silly. So you will say now to me, this is a different way of recitation. This is a totally different word. If I ask you right now,
and,
when Allah He says, I am going to create fil ardi khalifa,
mm-hmm.
khalifa, caliphate, I'm going to create.
Yes.
Okay. And this is about Adam, right?
Yes.
In different reading, it is khalifa. There's a huge difference between khalifa and khalifa. Khalifa is somebody to inherit. Khalifa is a creation. So this is not different reading. This is different words, have different meaning. So,
sir, I would also like to, pardon me, but I would also like to ask one more question, that do you respect our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon
him? No, I don't. Do he respect me to respect him? He called me dog. He called me filthy. He called me najis. He called me animal. He called me kuffar. He called me liar. He called me all names. And the top of that, he ordered you to attack me and kill me and take my wife. Why don't I respect him?
No, he didn't say it.
Okay, let's go. Chapter 9, verse 29. Read it for me.
Can you read it?
Huh?
Can you read it for me?
Would you go? I mean, you know, you are the Muslim, so read it.
Okay, I'll read it. But there are also rights of Christians written in the Quran. There are many rights.
There's what?
There are many rights. Prophet, peace be upon him, even allowed the Christians to pray in the Masjid-e-Nabvi.
Come on, this is all stories. You see, the Quran says, don't let the mushrikeen get closer from the Kaaba, for they are najis. And we are, according to you, mushrikeen. So don't give me those speeches. Those speeches were
no,
to somebody. What do you mean, no, sir?
No.
Are we mushrikeen or not? Are we mushrikeen as a Christian? Are we mushrikeen according to Islam or not?
No, respected brother. You are not mushrikeen. You are Ahle Kitab according to us. And we
okay,
can even
guys,
marry you.
Okay, my friend, what's your name?
No, sir. I cannot tell you my name.
Give me a name. Give me a name to call you with. What's your name? Give me a name. Give me a name.
Human.
Your name is a human. No problem. That's a good name, actually. Yeah. Your prophet, he don't deserve it. Anyway, listen to this. You just said that the Quran does not call us mushrikeen. Correct?
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
So now if I show you that the Quran says so, what you would do?
I would do research on it, and I would ask different scholars of Islam about this.
No. So when you say to me something, are you saying it because you are sure, or you are just making things up?
No, sir. I am sure about them, but I am just raising the point that there is contextual. There is context of seeing something.
Oh, context. Come on. Context. What context? The story is there. It says, those who say that Jesus is God, he is Allah, they are mushrikeen. Chapter 5, verse number 17. What shirk mean? What shirk mean? Refresh my memory. What the word mushrikeen mean?
Those who do shirk.
What does that mean?
Who associate partners with God.
Okay, we believe that Jesus is God, correct?
Yes.
Okay, that make us mushrikeen or not?
Yes, according to this definition.
Thank you. So you know, you speak, with my respect to you, with ignorance. confirming your ignorance, and you claim that you know you are a Muslim. Obviously, you are not. You are, you know, you don't have knowledge. Same time, your prophet, he says, وَإِنَّمَا الْمُشْرِكُونَ نَجِسِ. Those who they are mushrikeen, they are filthy. So don't let them enter the holy ground. In the same
time, sir, if this is the point, I would like to quote a verse from the Holy Quran. And that verse is in the Surah Araf. Hmm. And it is written that if anyone is a Muslim or a Christian or a Jew, but he does good deeds, so he will enter the paradise. It is written in Surah Araf.
Now, friend, this is when your prophet was without army. He was desperate to make anyone follow him. He did not know what to do. So he promised even the Sabian who worship the stars and the holy fire to be mm-hmm. in heaven. But those are people who don't even worship Allah. You see, mm-hmm. the Sabian, if you go and if you go and read their religion, and even though supposedly today the Sabian trying to present themselves in front of Muslims, that they are close mm-hmm. to the Muslims, but they are not. The Sabian mm-hmm. are people who they are worshipping stars, and they have a holy fire. And even Abraham, supposedly, he is one of them.
Mm-hmm.
You know the story of Abraham,
exactly.
right? Okay. So
yes,
Abraham
yes.
is one of them, and they are worshipping what? According to the Quran, those worship, idols. Idols for what? Idols of gods of sky, which yes. is stars, and etc. In chapter 6, yes. verse number 74, Abraham, he said to his father, Azar, are you going to worship idols as God? Okay, so how in the world, uh-huh. Muhammad, he said to the same people, you will go to heaven?
Yes.
This is crazy.
So brother, I will study these things, but I respect you. You are just like my elder brother. So, brother, I would just like to request you that please don't speak bad things about Prophet Muhammad. It's
no, my friend,
humble request.
I am here, you see, don't tell me please, etc. I'm here to expose this filthy man. He's a child molester, a person who is 54.
But brother, when I am respecting you and I am saying that you're my
brother. You don't have to respect me. Who cares if you respect me or not? This is not about respect. Don't be a fool. Who cares about respect? I respect you, respect me. This is garbage talk. We are talking about yes. faith here. We are talking about faith. We are not
and
talking
can
about...
I also ask you one question about Christianity directly?
Well, go ahead.
That is masturbation allowed in Christianity?
Well, Jesus was busy making the blind see. He is not busy talking about masturbation. This is what where Muhammad, he filled the gap. Muhammad is a person, he is busy with his penis, his testicles. He's busy with the virgins. Each time you sleep with them, Allah will put his finger there and he will make them virgin. You will have 70 years orgasm. Your penis will be endless. So Jesus was making the blind see, was walking in water, was healing the leper, was feeding thousands, and was forgiving sin. Muhammad was busy with the bathroom. When you enter the bathroom with your left foot, you will become invisible. If you don't, Shaitan will play with your anus. If you don't say a prayer before intercourse, Shaitan will rot himself around your penis and he will be doing your wife. This is why you are following a filthy man and we are following the Holy Messiah.
No, sir, I also respect Jesus Christ. He's
our
prophet.
I don't care if you respect, my friend. This is we are discussing the truth and facts. You don't have to agree with me. You keep saying I respect. If you respect Jesus, you don't say what you are saying about him.
No, sir. The thing is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us about all the things. He taught us about
Muhammad
the direct,
said that
dietary.
Allah, he promised me when Khadija was dying, he said, send my greeting to my wives. Khadija, she said to him, did you marry women before me? She was dying. He said, no. Allah, he promised me Asiya and Mary, the mother of Jesus. They will be my wives. So I respect you, my friend, and then I will sleep with your mother?
Yes.
Is that how you respect Jesus?
No, sir.
Okay, so where is the respect? Obviously, this man is ill, is sick. He want to have the wife of the Pharaoh. He want to have the sister of Moses, which is Mary, the mother of Jesus, according to him. So obviously, this person is sick. Anyone is famous. He want to have her in the bed. He worship himself.
I just asked you a simple question that I want to know that the adultery is forbidden in the Christianity. You agree with me that adultery is forbidden in Christianity?
Absolutely. Jesus, he said, even it's better for you to take your eye if it's going to mislead you and get you to take you to hell.
Likewise, I'm asking you a simple question that is masturbation allowed or not? It is a very simple question.
My friend, anything is not, let us say, it's not what God supposedly given you, it is not lawful. So the masturbation as a let us say, as a technique you do, it's nothing. But when you do masturbate, you will be thinking about someone else, right?
Yes.
Okay, that is the sin. Because you are not just masturbating. It's not that just the fluid is coming out. You are imagining, thinking. According to your prophet, it's okay. As an example, when a woman, she come to Muhammad, and she said to him, yes, I saw a wicked dream. Mm-hmm. Did Muhammad, he question how you do that? What you were dreaming about? You have no husband? No. All what he's worried about is washing her vagina. So Muhammad is a person, he is very silly. He don't go really for what is sin or what is not. Actually, the Quran says, hold on, my friend, you asked me a question, let me explain to you.
Yes.
Imagine me and you right now talking, and then a lady, she enter my room and she say, Christian Prince, I have a question. I was imagining myself having boom boom with the guy. Please, you are a prophet. Yes. Should I wash my vagina now? What is that? So the question for Muhammad was not about doing sin. The question is, should he wash her vagina or not? I mean, this is stupid religion. So he should say to her, well, you should not do that anyway. While you are imagining yourself with the man touching yourself, he said to her, wash your vagina. So now this is the problem, washing the vagina.
No, sir, like you quoted the verses of Gospel of Matthew, that if you look lustfully at the girl with the eye, so you can pop up the eye. So likewise, the prophet, it is even written in the Surah Nur in the chapter number 24, that lower your gaze and guard your modesty. So Islam also teaches us about modesty and guarding our eyes and our private parts. So it is also a very pure religion.
My friend, there's a video made just a few days ago. You can watch it in the channels of, I forget the name, about a guy, his name is Fifi and two other Muslims. And the title of it, yes, is it okay to be a pimp? And you are the one who mentioned the chapter of An-Nur, chapter 24.
Yes, chapter 24, yes. All right. Yes.
It's allowed for you to be a pimp. Go and watch the video. Those are three Muslims who hate me to death.
Yes.
The question was, and they said to them, they are speaking to them, each other. They said, brother, it sounds like it's okay to be a pimp. This is a permission to be a pimp. Watch the video on love. This is chapter 424, chapter 24, yes, verse number 33. It says that it is, don't force your girls to do prostitution. Prostitution, not only adultery. This is a pimp house.
Yes.
And yes, if you force them, Allah is all merciful. So there is no penalty in Islam, mm-hmm, for you being a pimp. And actually, if you force it, Allah is merciful. If they agree, it's a good deal, which means don't force them to do prostitution. So what if they're out, if they agree? If they agree, it's fine.
No, no.
Well, no, no, no. This is the verse in front of you, chapter 4, verse 24, and you can go watch the video. Somebody post the link, please. Admin, post the link about
No, sir. The verse is saying that you should not force the girls to prostitution. But if you do, but no, sir.
Okay, just okay. Hold on. I will go with you. You shall not force not your girls to do prostitution. If they force not. Okay.
Yes.
What if they don't force? If, because it says there's a condition. If they don't want. So if they want, it's okay.
No, this is so. This is related to common sense.
No, it's not up to you. The word is there. It says, "In aradna tahassuna." If they don't want, if they want chastity, they don't want to do that.
Yes.
Okay, force them not. So if they want that, then you can do so.
No, sir, that is also for. Brother, can you? Brother, can you give me just 1 minute?
Go ahead.
Sir, I'm just saying that when we take out the directives, we should read all the Quran, and all the Quran should be in our mind. So just,
listen, don't give me a speech. Trust me, I know the Quran from the beginning to the end. On the top of that, isn't it you as a Muslim believe that even prostitution or adultery, it is a destiny?
It is a destiny. What is the meaning of destiny? Can you please?
Destiny means Allah, He wrote for you that you are going to sleep with this woman and this woman and this woman. And then you have to do
that. No, that is forbidden.
What do you mean forbidden?
that it is not allowed. Prostitution is not allowed.
No, no, no. Listen, listen. Is it true that adultery, doesn't matter if prostitution or not now, adultery or in general, is it true that Allah, He wrote for you how many women you will sleep with, which you have to do? Yes or no?
I cannot understand your question.
Okay. Is it true that in the Allah, before He created you, He wrote
yes.
that Mr. Muhammad is going to sleep with a woman, her name is Fatima, and women, her name is Halima, and women, her name is Jonah, whatever. And then...
Okay. I understand your question, that you are asking that is it predestined, all these
yes,
things?
Yes.
I think that it will be predestined, as God has predestined all the things in
all
this
right.
world.
So how Islam forbid adultery if Allah is the one who is making you do adultery?
No, He has given us free will, but He knows that who will do the adultery and who will not do
the adultery. He knows, you see, you don't know what predestiny mean. Predestiny mean not He knows, it mean He decide for you. Okay, I want you, my friend, I want you to look with me in the screen. I have a hadith for you which is authentic.
Yes.
Go ahead, please read.
Yes, just give me 1 minute. I'm opening the screen. Just give me 1 minute. Yes.
All right.
Go ahead.
Can you read it?
Yes. Verily, Allah has fixed the very proportion of adultery.
Okay.
Can I go ahead?
What?
Verily, Allah has fixed the very proportion of adultery which a man will indulge in, and which he of necessity must commit. The adultery of the eye is the lustful look. And the adultery of tongue is the listless speech, the heart desires and yearns, which the parts may or may not be perfect.
Okay. You must commit. So Allah, He wrote for you how much adultery you would do, which you must commit. It's not a free will, as you said.
Yes.
Okay. So what this religion is about? This is stupid. So Allah, He decided
no,
for
sir.
Me. What do you mean, no, sir?
You have
perceived
the wrong... my brother, you have just perceived the wrong meaning of the hadith.
Okay, give me the real meaning. Go ahead.
So, sir, the right meaning is that Allah is basically saying Allah knows that adultery.
Why are adding words is not there? It says, Allah has fixed, not Allah knows. Allah has fixed. Read with me. I don't know what's wrong with Muslims when they're
yes.
reading. Are you blind?
Yes.
Allah has fixed the very portion of adultery which a man will indulge in. He is the one who fixed it for you. He did not say,
yes.
Allah, He knows how much you will do. It says, He is the one who fixed the very portion which a man will do of his necessity.
Yes.
He must commit. He must, does it say must commit?
Yes.
Okay. So, if there's no choice to change in the future and not to do it, there's no choice to be good or bad, for Allah, He wrote for you the very portion of adultery which a man will indulge in. So it's not about
yes.
Allah, He knows. It's about Allah, He decides
yes.
for you.
Yes. So you Christians do not believe in predestination?
No, we don't believe in such a thing, because this is why Jesus said, not everyone says to me, God, God, will enter the kingdom of my Father, but the one who do His will. This is why Jesus said,
okay.
When the Jews, they crucified Him in the cross, He said, forgive them, Father. They do not know what they are doing. Because if it was a predestiny, why He will forgive them? You know?
So, sir, likewise, this scene is also in the Taif, when the Prophet ﷺ was persecuted
friend,
by the people.
This is not Da'if, this is Sahih Hadith. Secondly, it's all over the Quran. The Quran says so. Predestiny is so clear. And even your Prophet, he claimed, that even the sin of Adam was a predestiny. Allah, He decided for him to commit sin 40 years before He created him. Correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So why Allah
okay,
He created Adam?
So I will do.
All right. So if Allah he forced Adam to commit sin, why He kicked Adam from heaven?
Because it was also the free will. There is also written in the Quran that Allah has given us free will. That is why we are ashraful.
My friend, where is the free will? I mean, am I talking to myself? If Allah, He wrote for you the destiny you will do, and then even Adam,
mm-hmm.
he did not commit sin. Allah forced him to commit sin, and you keep saying to me free will.
I will read about these things.
All right.
Okay, so, brother. So thank you.
Anything else I can help you with?
Can you also tell me about any application of Bible that is available on App Store that I can read?
Well, you know, for me, there's nothing that's called application. God is not a book. God is not application. God is the one who make you a better person. So if a book yes. will fail to make you a better person, this is a book of the devil. As simple as that. So when the Quran says you can go and do muta, this is not God talking for sure. When the Quran says uh-huh. that God will give you women with big boobs, this is an insult to your mother and my mother, your sister and my sister. Because women is not, they are human like us, and we are born yes. from them. We should not speak about them. They are just boobs. So
yes.
a word of God is not an application. A word of God is the miracle which can change you and can change me to be better people. So look around mm-hmm. you now. Is the Muslims better people because of Islam, or they are burning the earth around them and around their neighbors?
Sir, I am also Muslim, but I never committed adultery.
My friend,
or
because
never...
you are not a Muslim. If you are a Muslim, you will do what Muslims do. You're a prophet, even he forbid.
No.
Okay, let me ask
no.
you.
No.
Are you yes. Are you allowed to do farming?
Farming?
Yeah.
Yes, we are allowed to do farming.
Muhammad, he said that those who do farming, they will go to hell.
Where it is written, please give me reference.
We can find the hadith. Let me search. Let me remember the hadith, what the hadith is saying. Because he wants you to be a war warrior, and those
yes.
who do that, you know, let us see if I can find it. I'm trying to remember the hadith.
Sir, one more thing, that please also do not reveal my identity, as I do not want my identity to be revealed.
You want what?
Sir, I basically want to hide my identity.
I'm not showing your identity, my friend. And always you can call me, change or give yourself whatever name you want. I don't know. I don't share. This is why I told
thank you.
This is why I told you. Give me a name to call you with. You know, I don't care who you are. Right?
God bless you. God bless you, brother.
You're welcome. I'm just trying to remember the hadith. You see, sometime your memory fail you.
Sir, can you please tell me that which translation of the Quran have you read, of which scholar?
I do not read the translation. I speak Arabic. Arabic is my first language. When I share here translation, I share because you guys don't speak Arabic. You know.
Oh, so you know how to speak Arabic.
I'm an Arab.
Oh, nice.
Okay. So this is why I say to you, it says, in aradna tahassuna. So, you know, if they choose desire, if they choose chastity, mm-hmm. then, so what if they choose not, then it's okay. Right? Yeah. So, actually, let me see. I think I found the hadith.
Yes.
And here you will see that Muhammad is a very evil person. Read with me carefully.
Yes.
It says here, this is not the one I want. They posted the hadith, but this is not the one I want. Yeah, this is not the one you want. Yeah, no, there's a hadith. This is a different hadith. I will try to remember it. Yeah, there's a hadith clearly. Muhammad, he says that like the one who have those equipment, agriculture equipment, Allah will humiliate him. Allah literally
yes.
will humiliate this person. And then you ask yourself, why in the world such a thing will happen to a person, for he is doing farming where we will eat? Because Muhammad, he want criminals who go yeah. after. Here we go. I found it, actually. Here we go. Abu Umama on saying long share and come to agriculture in equipment or etc. He told that he had heard the prophet saying that this is will not enter any people's house without God causing ignominy to enter it. This is Al-Bukhari. So just because you have equipment of farming in your house, Allah will humiliate
yes.
this house. Why? What is the problem exactly? What the sin? What sin mm-hmm. they committed? So who is going to feed the Muslims?
I will do research on this.
Who is going to feed the Muslim, my friend? This is Al-Bukhari. Who is going to feed the
yes.
Muslims? So the one who mm-hmm. have equipment of agriculture, he will be humiliated by Allah. So who
Billy, are you Catholic or Protestant?
My friend, there's not such a thing, Catholic or Protestant. Jesus, he is the Lord, and this is what we worship. We don't worship a pope, we don't worship a priest. The man who follow a man, he will die with the man. The one who follow God, that is the Messiah, he will live forever. So those questions, they don't count for me.
So do you consider Jesus as God?
Yes, he's my Lord. He's my Savior, absolutely.
No, but he was the prophet of God. He was not God. As how can the God be crucified?
My friend, how can God be crucified and come back if he is not God?
Yes.
You see, so why we ask ourselves, you see, I want you to be smart. You know, I believe you are a smart person. But, you know, yes, you grow up in a society and you repeat the questions, you heard it. How Jesus can be God, he was crucified. The question is, well, did Jesus go and never come back? Did Jesus get killed and that's it? He was a loser or victorious? So let us say I am a person who is wearing bulletproof. And then people shoot at me. And then, okay, because they shot too many shots, I am now in the ground. And even they buried me. But the second day, yes, I came back to them and I say I'm alive. So how, yes, that can be done for a human like me and you? Is that normal?
Yes. So I have one more question. That if you consider Jesus as God, then in all the previous Abrahamic religions, Jesus should also be considered God. But in the Judaism, there was one God. But in the Christianity, there's Trinity.
Now,
so why is this?
One God is the Trinity, is not the opposite. Because simply, when we say one God, we are not adding additional God. The Trinity is one God. We believe, we Christian, when we pray, we say our Father. We don't say our fathers. Yes. Have you ever seen a Christian saying our fathers? No.
No.
Our Father. Why? Because we believe in one God. So he's one God, but our God, he is present between us, or he told us about himself, that he is a spirit, which means he's between us,
yes,
but we cannot see him. And he come to us as a flesh, that is the word, which is God.
Yes.
Come to us in the flesh. And he, in the same time, he is in heaven. That is the Father.
Yes.
So three person, one God. So if we say, how that can be possible, that's very easy. If you go in the Quran, yes, you will see that Jesus, and he is, in the Quran, he is just a prophet, right?
Yes.
Okay. The Quran said that Jesus is the word of God, correct?
Yes.
Okay. This word, Allah, he sent it down to Mary, correct?
Yes.
All right. This word became a man, correct?
Yes.
This word have a spirit, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So if we go in the Quran, read the chapter 4, verse 171, we will see that the same verse is saying no Trinity is the same verse saying you can be three and one at the same time. Read with me, yes, carefully. Chapter 4, verse 171. All people of the book, commit no excuse in your religion, nor say of Allah thought but the truth. Christ Jesus, the Son of Mary, was, between two brackets, this Muslim translation, no more than, okay, a messenger of Allah. So take a note, he is just a man, correct?
Yes.
All right. And then,
yes,
and he is his word. So he's what? He's the word of Allah, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And he bestowed that word on Mary, and a spirit proceeding from him. From him who? From God, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So let us put it together. The same verse saying, don't say Trinity, which means you cannot be one and three in the same time. Do we agree?
Yes.
All right. So.
No, please repeat the question, what you were saying.
The verse saying, don't say Trinity. Don't say three,
yes,
and one. Trinity is three and one, right? Three, which is,
yes,
one. Okay.
Yeah.
So don't say Trinity, yes, but the same verse says, there's different kind of Trinity. Look at this. He just said that the Messiah, he was sent,
yes,
down first in a form of a word. He was a word. So,
yes,
before the Messiah become a man, he was what? He was a word.
So, sir, my question was, hold on.
Jesus was what? The word, right? Do you agree?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
If we go to John chapter 1, you see, in the beginning it was the word, and the word was with God, and the word is the God. That is Jesus.
Yes.
Okay. So, for us as a Christian, the second you say Jesus is the word, you are saying Jesus is God. Simple. Because the word of God is God. God without his word does not exist. God's word is the Logos. And the Logos is what God, the will of God. Let me continue. So Jesus is the word sent down to who? To Mary, right?
Yes.
Okay, this word become what? Become a man, correct?
Yes.
John chapter 1, verse number 14. And the word became a flesh. So Muhammad is copying John chapter 1 and putting it in this verse, trying to fight the Trinity. Hold on, my friend. So look what happened to Jesus now. He is a flesh. He's a messenger.
Yes.
Transformed from the Word. In the same time, he is a spirit proceeding from God. Do you see the ing in your translation?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
I am not, and you are not proceeding from Allah. You are not.
Yes.
To make it clear for you, God created Adam and Eve, and then he gave Adam and Eve the ability of reproduction, correct?
Yes.
Okay, to reproduce. In the case of Jesus, he himself is the Spirit of God, not from Adam.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, so he is the Word, he is a messenger, which means he's a man, and he is the Spirit of God in the same time. Three but one in the same time. How that can be?
So, sir, my question was very simple, that why isn't the concept of Trinity present in Judaism? Why it is not present in
Judaism? It is. If you go right away from the book of Genesis, you will see that God and his Spirit, right away, the Spirit of God. And then God, he came to Abraham as a man. This is why Jesus said, before Abraham, I am. The Jews, they said to him, well, you are not even 50 years old. What do you mean?
Yes.
You know, before Abraham you are. He says that truly, truly, I say to you, that Jesus, he saw my day and he rejoiced for it. So the Bible speaks clearly in many verses about the Trinity as a word does not exist in the Bible. The same as the word Tawheed. If we go in the whole Quran, we will not find the word Tawheed in the Quran. There's no Tawheed. So the Trinity is just a word we use today to present the faith, what is the Trinity is. Instead of saying Father, Son, Holy Spirit, we say Trinity. But that word itself is not the important. The important is what we believe in the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. But as you see, when the Muslims, they say, that is not, that is impossible. Well, here we go. Your prophet, he present to us something impossible too. Jesus is the Spirit of God. The Quran says, وَجَعَلْنَاهُ نَسَبًا وَصَهْرًا. We made every creature, which means every creature since Adam, you know, by lineage, by sexual relationship, but by marriage. If you go and read the interpretation, you will see exactly what I am saying. But Jesus is not from a sexual relationship. Do we agree?
Yes.
All right. So Jesus is an exception from chapter 25, verse number 54.
Yes, his birth was miraculous.
Exactly. This is why Muhammad, he says, وَكُلَّ ابْنَ آدَمٍ خَطَّى. Every son of an Adam is a sinner, correct? Jesus is not. Yes. Jesus is not. Why? Because he is not son of Adam. He is not from the lineage of Adam. He is not coming from sexual relationship. So Jesus is different in everything, even in your Quran. He is the word of God. He is holy. Chapter 19, verse number 19. The Holy Son. The angels say to Mary, we are here to give you the glad tidings of Holy Son. So Jesus never commits sin. Jesus from above. Jesus said, I am from above. You are from below. How we can explain that? I am not of this world. You are of this world. So Jesus made it clear that he is not from this world. He don't belong here. So Jesus, when he said that, either you can say this guy is crazy, saying crazy stuff. You think he is coming from different galaxy, or you have to accept that Jesus making it clear that he's God. And yet the Muslim, they say to us, where Jesus is, God worship me. when Jesus said, before Abraham I am, the Muslim, they will say to you, and you are a Muslim, okay, Jesus was born in the year of etc. So where was the Trinity before? Right?
Yes.
Well, Jesus said that the answer is with Jesus. He said, before Abraham I am. So his existence have nothing to do with his birth.
So, sir, now I'm a little busy. I have to do work.
Well, you are welcome, and I'm happy that you called me, and I invite you to leave Islam right away, because Islam is nothing but an ugly cult, and deception, and it's not from God.
Sir, but please do not reveal my identity.
No
please.
Problem. No worry, my friend. Go ahead. Take care.
Okay.
Take care.
Allah. Okay, love.
Okay. Always, if you are a Muslim, change your name, the one you use in your Skype, and I will not know about it. Nobody will know about it anyway. He's a nice guy, right? We have to agree. He's a gentleman, trying to understand. And this is why we are here. This is why we are here. Muhammad is an evil person. Even farming, because all mankind, they live because of a farmer, correct? I mean, what we eat today, what you ate today, there is somebody is feeding you. Muhammad don't want that. Muhammad want criminals. Why he will get upset because somebody doing farming? Because he's evil. What exactly should be our job? Your job, you go, you attack the farmer, you take his wife, you take his chicken, you take his cow, you slaughter them, you eat them, you have fun. And then, second day, we attack other farmer. This is a very evil man. Based on this, all the Muslims who do farming in the world, Indonesian, where are you, stars, Indonesians? How many farmers you have in Indonesia? All of Indonesia, maybe it's farmers. According to this, Allah will humiliate you. And let me pause the link. You see, sometime, like, I mean, I have billions of hadith in my head. I don't know, I mean, stories. And sometime, like, you're going to find something and, like, the idea did not come right away. You know, I mean, this is what happened to you when you became 110 years old. Let me post the link for you guys so you can save it. So if later I mention it, you will have it. All right? Did we have a good time? Now this person, I encourage him to go check everything. Actually, everything I said, I showed him in the screen, right? I didn't make a speech. We don't make speeches here. Muslim, they open their channels bashing the Bible. Look what the Bible says. Like a guy in the comment section, he says, in Luke, it says your servant Jesus approved of slavery. What the heck? Jesus dead? But Jesus never owned a slave. What is that? He said in the book of Luke. We go to the book of Luke. The same verses he's asking us for. We will find that this is about servant who serve God. This is not about real servant. When they are desperate, trying to find anything against Christianity. And yes, in the Old Testament, there's a slaves. A Hebrew slave can be a slave for 7 years. He offered himself as a slave. And there's a slave of a war. The Jews themselves, they became a slave of the whole nation, eye for an eye. Those people, they are fighting to survive. Even we showed you just a few days ago, if you remember, we made a video, when this guy, he debated David Wood, which is a funny debate from both of them. Both of them, they are acting like kids. I don't know how those people, they call those debates our debate. But anyway, even in your religion, when the Muslims speak about the book of Numbers, we will find that in the interpretation says that the enemies, they killed all the Jewish women and only one woman left. And this is the woman, she gave birth to Shaul. Can you talk about chapter 65, 4? Maybe next time, my friend, because this is a different topic for now. But anyway, and you know, we are here for a while. Now I noticed that YouTube is down the numbers of my view. So we understand that YouTube is fighting my videos. I understand, because it doesn't make sense, you know. I mean, I saw the videos, my video, previous video. In the morning I wake up, I said to myself, let me see, because I promised them if it's 20,000 I will go live again. So I look, it was 17,000. Then I look afternoon, it is 14,000. Can you believe it? So 6 or 7 or 8 hours after, and instead of having more than 20,000-25,000, we have 14. It was 17,000 in the morning. So obviously, the Abdul in YouTube, they are playing games with me. Because I said, I will go live when it is 20. So they said themselves, okay, we will put it down always. So you will not go live. So my friend, we will go live and we will save the Muslims. We don't hate them and we don't want you to hate them. They are lost and they need somebody to help them. And we are here to help. This person, he will go right now. He will check everything I said, everything I showed him the screen. We did not say a single thing we did not show in the screen, which is their own words, their own translation, and they cannot deny it. Can they? They cannot. When Muhammad, he says that Mecca and Medina, sorry, is protected and no plague will enter it and no corona will enter it, and then we'll find that people die by tens of thousands. Muhammad is a fraud. And right now, for the last 2 years, the whole two cities almost blocked, closed down, shut down. If there's no plague can enter the city, why you shut it down? Why people are dying there? So you do not need to be a genius to know that Muhammad is a fraud. You do not need to be a genius. So I'm here to help the Muslims, and you can tell this is why those who claim to have knowledge, they don't dare to call me, because they will look like a bunch of fool. I bet you this gentleman who called us, he think he have a lot of knowledge, but suddenly he notice he know nothing. This is why those who have long beard, they avoid calling me, because it's going to be a very bad embarrassment. Where we can find source that Allah has a golden bed. Golden bed, this is like, you know, this is a... we can find source not only about golden bed, it's about Allah being carried, he's a throne, not a bed. He's being carried by a chair, he have a chair, carried by eight angels. And then the Muslims, they add their own fictions to this chair. That is like a chandelier, and the heaven will be underneath of the chair, and blah, 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 etc. But this will be a different story for maybe another time. Can you talk about Zakaria Butros? Yeah, my friend, there is no need to talk about Zakaria Butros. If you know this person, support him. He's a wonderful man. Sort of the jinn, we spoke about it today already. What we will talk about it. You can go and read the interpretation of the Quran where it says that Allah's chair will be carried by eight, and then we find those eight. They are supposedly eight angels who have four faces, each one of them. And then it says that they are four goats, mountain goats. Go to chapter 69, verse number 17. All right. And then read the interpretation. You will find more description about those stories. Let us find. Here we go. There's eight, I don't know what the name in English for those animals. Elk, eight elk. Okay, it says here. And above them, above there is eight mountains, goat. Mountain goat, the distance between whose hoof and the lunches and the haunches is like the distance between heaven and the next heaven. My friend, the Christian Savior, stop repeating yourself. I answered you. Go and read the interpretation for those verses. Why people are, you know, they keep repeating, repeating, repeating. And what, you know, and do you think I'm just here to show you tons of endless reference? Come on. Don't we have enough? I just answered you. You don't want to do any job. You want me to go and open the pages and flip the pages for you. I read the pages. You don't want to do anything. I just told you, go and read the interpretation for the verses. Where we can find? Where we can find? Where we can find? You don't want to do anything. You will see now, I will finish the video and then I'll go to Patreon. I will see somebody saying, where I can find this reference? I just posted. They are lazy. They don't want to do anything. And they think I have nothing to do except just, and what make it really make me upset from people is, I stay for hours with them, posting reference, showing reference. And after I finish, they ask me for the same reference, or they ask me questions when I'm done. A friend, if you have a question, ask it here. You ask me a question, I answer you. This is one of the funny things about people here, that no matter how many times I repeat even the same topic, they ask me for the reference. Or a person will say to me, where I can find the reference in your book? My friend, it's in the book. Where I can find the reference which is in your book? I mean, do you see the madness? Like last time I finished my podcast, I saw the text, but it was too late. I said, like, God bless you, and I'm done. Somebody saying, where can I find the reference of your book, Six in the Law? My friend, it's in the book. It is in the reference there. It says, this is in the book of etc., page etc. And you're asking me where we can find the reference of your book? What's wrong with people? So why I'm giving you there the name of the book and the page number? People, they drive you crazy, my friend. Where I can find the reference in your book? Do you remember the Fifi? He says, I cannot find the reference in Christian Prince introduction. The first page, they could not find it. 5-6 Muslims, they start looking, they could not find it. And then we get them busted in 2 seconds. I mean, a kid, he can find it right away. And they made a video about it and a scandal. Christian Prince, the introduction is not there. He is making things up. And then people start laughing at them. Just use your brain. Listen carefully to the conversation I just have with this person, and I want you to ask yourself how we can have similar conversation with a Muslim. The answer is very easy. Build your knowledge before he talk. Before he finish his talk, I have an answer for him. Before he even finish the question, I have the answer for him. That not because there's two people who just love to talk. You have to talk and make sense. So this person, he retreat. You have no answer what he can say. He cannot deny it. He cannot say it's not true. Why? Because knowledge is power. Ignorance is shame. And you as a Christian, you are following the God of knowledge. That's why Jesus said, read the books. He ordered you to read the books. Search the truth. And when you find it, the truth will set you free. That is God. God is the one who set me free, not the one who make me Abdul, slave. God do not need slaves. He is almighty. What I will do to him, I will cut a tree. I will cook a sandwich. What I can do to God? Nothing. So the true God, the true Lord which we follow, he do not need slaves. This is why Jesus, when they ask him how to pray to God, he said, say this, our Father. We have a Father. We are children in his kingdom. They are slaves. We are free in his kingdom, they are slaves. We are free from our needs. When Jesus said, he and she, they will not get married in heaven, which means they will not have sex. You know what Jesus is talking about? He said you will be the same as angels. You will not be an angel, but you are the same as angels, which mean God will free you from all your needs. This is the freedom. You are not under any kind of needs. In Islam, you are slave of needs. You go to heaven, Allah will increase your horny desire 100 times. So you wish to do it maybe once a day, once a week in earth. In heaven, you cannot stop having sex. He make you addicted. He make you slave of your penis and your vagina. With Jesus, you are free. You are free from all the needs. And that will make you a true child of God. And in the heaven of Christ, if God cannot make me happy without food, what kind of God is God is? In the heaven of Islam is nothing but big boobs, falafel. Actually, there's not even falafel. There's only meat of birds. I mean, there's not even a cheese kebab, which is stupid. He said to me, whatever you wish, and then the buffet is just bird food. So when we speak about the Messiah, when we speak about the Messiah, we speak about the Lord. He wants us to be free. He wants us to be children of God. He do not need slaves. Jesus never owned one. Jesus, he never charged people for service. Jesus, he never asked kings to build him palaces. Imagine if you have the power of Christ today. You can bring people from death. How many people are willing to pay all the money they have if you can bring me back from death? How many? How many kings would love to have such a person? Each time they die, he brings them back to life. So, with the Messiah, we are a new people. A man saying, as if you don't have a desire for that. A man, thank you for saying that. This is showing me that Islam is, you know, Muhammad is a stupid man, and his God proven to be stupid too, because he could not make you smart. The sex desire, my friend, it was not meant to be a desire for sex. It was desire to have a family. This is why God, he created Adam and Eve, not Adam and 72 Eves. So with your religion, you made nothing except everything is about sex. With the Messiah, Adam and Eve was created to have a family, a man who love a woman who love a man, not a man and hundreds of chickens as a rooster. So your God is the God of the lost. So God gave me a sexual desire to have a family, but not to be a pimp. In your religion, Muhammad, he made you a pimp. You exchange women as a changing shoes. The value of marriage does not exist. Women is just a sex toy. Just do it legally. And they call it halal. You go, you ask a woman to sleep with you, go to the ma'zoon. How much you charge me? I will sleep with you 2 days, 3 days, and then I divorce you, and then I get another woman. Or I can divorce every day 4 women and marry new 4 women second day. Because there's no marriage in Islam. It's just a prostitution. Right? That you are not a man? Is that what you are saying? Well, my friend, I do not need to prove to you that I'm a man. I don't want to be rude to you. Because a man is not about having sex. Because if what make you a man is having sex, that means all donkeys are men. And by the way, your prophet, he cannot have sex. This is why the Quran says, وَإِنَّ شَنِئَكَ لَأَبْتَرْ. The one who accused me that you are cut off, he is the one who is cut off. So your prophet is the one who said in the hadith, I was the most weak person in between mankind in boom boom. And then I invoke my God, and then he sent me a dish of shish kebab. I ate it, I get the power of 40 men. So based on you, you are saying that your prophet wasn't a man because he was the lowest between all mankind. How you can beat that? And here we notice Muhammad is again being a fool. Since when shish kebab will give you the power of 40 men? And what kind of God, he cannot fix the penis of his prophet unless he made shish kebab for him in his kitchen. I thought God, he can make you strong very easy. They say, hey, Muhammad, penis fixed. Bing! Muhammad, penis is strong. But no, Allah have to go to the kitchen, buy some spices and Indian curry, mix it with some beef, and then he make like word, like chicken, voodoo, you know? And then he send it with Jibreel. And then Jibreel come to Muhammad. Muhammad, and Muhammad now his penis is not working. He said, who is this? Hey, Muhammad, don't feel down, man. Don't feel down. The solution is coming here. Here we go. Allah, he just sent him a dish. Send you a dish. Eat it, and you will see what will happen. Muhammad, he says, man, I tried everything. It's not going to work. I played even the anthem. He's not standing up. Jibreel says, trust me. This is the recipe of Allah. He went to the kitchen and he did it. He said, I'm telling you, it's not going to work. I played the music, did not work. Anthem did not stand up. It's nothing working. I told you, I'm the most weak, you know, most weak person between all mankind. And boom, boom. And she said, try it and you will see. And then Muhammad, he put the first bite. The second he put the first bite, brother, his penis start like moving. The second bite became an antenna. The third bite, he was jumping like a mule. And what make it more funny, that Fatima, she ate with him. So I don't know if Fatima, she got the power of 40 men too. That is a different story. So anyway. Are you saying you're the man? This is what make you a man. Your prophet have 13 wives. He could not have a baby from any of them. I wonder what is that. And you know, when a woman, she came to Muhammad and she said that she have a wet dream. And she's talking about washing her vagina. So, you know, she's saying that she have orgasm. So the wife of Muhammad, she said, do the woman have this charge? Do you see it? This is the wife of your prophet. Your prophet never, never, ever made her have this charge. And you are talking who is the man? This is the wife of Muhammad. Make it clear that this powerful man who got the power of 40 men after eating the dish of shish kebab, he never was able to make his wife have orgasm. And she is asking the husband, like, what the heck? Women have this charge? What? Do you see it? This is the wife of your prophet. The laundry is out. Now, everybody knows in the world now, thank the Muslims, they report for us the story, knows that Muhammad, he was not using his penis for sure. He was using lipstick. Prove me wrong. She never ever heard that there's a woman, she can have orgasm. And who is she? She is the wife of Muhammad. So what Muhammad was doing in the bed? Watching cartoon? Like, what the heck? Hey, Muhammad, the wife is... I don't want to go in details, but I feel sorry for this woman. So her husband, the husband, he go around, he says, I was yesterday with all the wives. No wonder he was with all the wives. He was doing nothing. The hadith says he used to go to his wife, boom, boom, all of them. He was doing nothing. He was shaking hands. In the best scenario, shaking boobs. But as you see, this wife, she's, you see, this is proof not only this woman, she never has charge, even the other wives, because they speak to each other. She never heard, ever. That there is a woman, she have this charge. Like, what? It's like first time watching Discovery Channel. And then Muhammad have to explain to her. He says, yeah, sure. Otherwise, how the child resembled his mother? Look at the genius too. So this charge make you resemble your mother. Can you believe it, the stupidity? This charge of the women is the reason to resemble your mother. Look at the genius, Muhammad. Different hadith says that the one who comes first, the baby will look like him, which means a male or female, and look will look the same too. So if you are ugly, if you are not good looking, regardless if you are male or female, please, please don't have orgasm first. We have enough ugly people in this earth. I mean, look at me. Hello? Anyway, I think we have enough for today. Did we have a good time? I think yes, we did. So please don't forget to leave your comment, because comment will increase the view of people. People will share, and feel free to say something. I mean, you watched the whole video. You have nothing to say? Are you a piece of wood? Are you a watermelon? Are you a goat? Nothing moved you? Nothing make you think? Nothing make you question? Nothing make you answer? Because if nothing can move you after all of this, that means you are not really exist. You are just a watermelon. Somebody will open you, put you in the fridge, and that will happen sooner or later. So don't be a watermelon. Don't. Be human who use his brain. And the Lord, he gave us an amazing gift. Why you don't put to leave a single video? We have many videos about him. Go watch them. I mean, why this one only? Who care? When I put a video, people don't watch the one. The last videos, they focus on it, and they forgot the video before it. So that video, because I wanted them to watch the video before it, which is way more important than the stupid to leave a single. Already we got him busted many times. What a big deal. Anyway, thank you guys for being here. May the Lord bless you all. And I hope that the gentleman who called me today, he will call me next time leaving Islam. And I think he will. This is why he was worrying about his identity. He is thinking seriously that he don't want to be Muslim no more. So I think this is the scenario. So we pray for this person, pray for him to be saved, pray for his family to see the truth, pray that every Muslim will see how stupid this religion is, and they will get out of it. I remember one thing, that with Christ, impossible is possible. So if it is impossible to make a Muslim believe, you are wrong. Because with Christ, it is possible. It's not a Christian prince who make a Muslim believe. It is the Lord who help to open their eyes. Remember, they have to come to him and knock at his door, and then he will open for them. So for us, we show them the way, we share the truth, we make them think, and then they have to ask the Lord to answer, and the Lord will answer. So Christ will open their eyes if they choose their eyes to be open, free will. We don't believe in destiny. So with your free will, invite Jesus to your house, and he will be there. Jesus, he said, every two of you mention my name, I will be between them. So today we spoke about him many times, he is with us. And that can happen to you, Muslims. Invite Christ, his name is amazing. His name is a miracle, and he is a miracle. The Messiah is the walking, talking, living word of God. Not only he do miracle, but yet he is the miracle. And the miraculous Christ is going to come back, and that day will be a judgment day, where all mercy in the world cannot help you, because it's going to be too late. So accept him before it is too late. God bless you, and see you soon again. Take care.